With 2020 behind us, it's time to really focus on your digital marketing game. And in this video, I'll compare Canva and Adobe Spark to see which solution will help you drive your message to the masses in 2021. So strap on in because we're starting right now. First up is Canva. If you're new to the solution, it's a web-based design tool that allows you to create some really great looking digital assets. They offer hundreds of different design elements and templates, all of which can be easily customized for your business or project. Most of the assets are free, but Canva does offer a paid version called Pro. Canva also offers free background music and stock photos, which can be used for both commercial and personal projects. Now, on the flip side, Adobe Spark, for the most part, looks and feels just like Canva. They offer a large library of elements and templates for you to choose from, but they don't offer any background music or stock videos. Having used Canva for more than 5 months now, I'm so surprised at how well optimized it is. I've designed projects with countless elements on the canvas and noticed, you know, little to no dips in performance. Even when adding animations and background video and music and a crazy number of elements, Canva handled everything with no problem. Now, Adobe Spark is another story. I found their solution to be a bit laggy and not really well optimized across different browsers. Not to mention the loading times when first logging in and choosing a template. Now, this might be due to my laptop performance, but having tested Spark on different computers and, you know, laptops, that theory was proven incorrect as it still struggles to perform. Now switching back to Canva, for the most part, the solution allows you to customize most, if not all, the elements. You can choose colors of an element, add cool effects, and even add adjustments to an image to brighten it up. But at the end of the day, you're boxed in by the different elements that they offer. Now Adobe Spark also has good amounts of customization, and just like Canva, you can change, you know, element colors, add effects, and also do some image enhancements. But just like its competitor, you're stuck with the elements you're offered with no ability to, you know, create custom shapes or elements. Now let's talk numbers, because both Canva and Adobe Spark will set you back nothing to get started. You can create great assets with their free solution. With Canva, you get the access to templates, popular fonts, stock images, design elements, and so much more. Now, if you want the premium stock images, the audio, the video, and the ability to set up and maintain a brand identity, then Canva Pro will set you back $12.95 per month. While Adobe Spark only costs $9.99, and with that, you get premium templates, the ability to set up and maintain a team, CC libraries, and an epic selection of fonts, guys. And there you have it, my friends. Although both options have their drawbacks, I feel like Canva came out as the better solution, in my opinion. Now, I drank the Adobe Kool-Aid a long time ago, but at the end of the day, I feel like Adobe Spark still needs some time to work out the kinks. But these are just my opinions, so go online and test to see which solution works best for you. With that said, I hope this video helps you when making your decision. And as always, thank you so much for joining me here on Under Budget Marketing Design, a channel for understaffed marketers, small business owners, and do-it-yourselfers. Please make sure you like and subscribe, and I'll catch you in the next episode of Under Budget Marketing Design.